NASA and SpaceX have been working for nearly a decade to return humans to the moon for the first time since the 1970s. Was it that long ago? Wow. Anyways, after years of development and billions of dollars, both rockets are stationed on their launch pads, ready to blast off on their first flights, most likely within the next few months. The biggest question is, how do these two rockets compete with each other? You're curious to know more about this, right? Yeah, I feel you. So we're going to talk about that. But first, we'd like to welcome you to our channel, Liftoff, where we post daily updates from the world of space. So if you like our videos and want to stay on track, subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to never miss out on any of our space-related news. Let's take a look at the history and development of Starship and SLS today, as well as everything else required for the Artemis missions, such as design considerations and capabilities. Right off the bat, we have to make one thing clear. NASA and SpaceX are not rivals in any way. We have to make our peace with it. Let's remember that. So how did we end up here in the first place? Two of the most powerful rockets ever built are being launched simultaneously? Well, let's get started because we have a lot to cover. Since early February, the Starship rocket has been on a launch pad at SpaceX's test site in Texas. On March 21st, SpaceX CEO stated that the company's maiden orbital flight will take place in May, assuming that the rocket's engines are manufactured and deployed on time. The Space Launch System, which you could short to SLS, which was just brought out to a launch pad at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, is aiming for a similar launch window. On the other hand, in 1969, NASA made history by sending humans to the moon with Apollo 11. When Artemis 3 sends the first woman and the first person of color to the moon in 2025, it wants to achieve the same. The SpaceX launch system, a massive under-development rocket, will be used to accomplish this. Of course, the SLS we're talking about. SpaceX has similar big aspirations. The Starship, a fully reusable rocket capable of delivering humans to the moon, Mars, and beyond, is now being tested by businesses. But first, SpaceX intends to take Japanese billionaire Yasuko Maezawa and a crew of specifically selected passengers around the moon aboard the Starship. This mission was first announced in 2018 with a launch date of 2023. However, an orbital test flight of the Starship has yet to be completed. Meanwhile, after rolling out its huge rocket on Friday, March 18th, NASA took a historic step toward launching the SLS with a wet dress rehearsal. Despite their disparate missions, the SLS and Starship provide remarkably comparable functions, which is even more remarkable given NASA's ambitions to utilize the Starship to land astronauts on the moon. Here's how these two rockets compare as they head for the moon. The SLS rocket, which measures 322 feet tall with its upper stage, Orion, is slightly shorter than the Saturn V rocket, which launched American humans to the moon in 1969 and has a 15% greater thrust force, which means it can lift a larger tonnage. SpaceX's whole Starship is 394 feet tall, making it the world's highest rocket. According to Musk, the initial version, optimized for Earth orbital travel, will have around 500,000 pounds, that's 230 tons of thrust power at sea level. Speaking of thrust, the thrust generated by the SLS is significant, although it varies depending on the configuration. 8 million pounds are produced by the Block 1 version, 9 million pounds are produced by the Block 1B version, 5 million pounds are produced by the Block 2 version. The Super Heavy rocket on the Starship, on the other hand, will provide 17 million pounds of thrust at liftoff. We talked about the specifications, now let's talk about the cost. The Space Launch System, it's not going to be inexpensive. According to Ars Technica, launching the rocket once a year might cost more than $2 billion. It was revealed in March 2022 that it could cost up to $4.1 billion due to the efficiency gains from reusing a rocket. Musk predicted in November 2019 that a Starship launch could cost as little as $2 million per spin. The Starship is intended to launch from the Starbase facility near Boca Chica, Texas. Musk also stated in December 2021 that the ship might launch from Launch Complex 39A at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, which is presently utilized by SpaceX for their Falcon rockets. NASA will launch the SLS from Launch Complex 39B, which is just next to 39A. Would you have guessed? Neither SpaceX nor NASA has shown that their rockets can reach Earth's orbit, which is a requirement for further space exploration. The test results for Starship are more promising. SpaceX has flown five high-altitude test flights to a height of 10 kilometers with various prototypes of the Starship's upper stage to date. Its next mission, which will include the launcher, will aim for Earth orbit, which begins at 160 kilometers. The test won't reveal if the Starship is ready to travel to the Moon or Mars. However, if successful, it'll be a significant step forward in Musk's ambition for interplanetary travel, allowing SpaceX to deploy the rocket for regular Starlink launches in the near future. The SLS rocket was supposed to launch in March but has been postponed. NASA is continuing to test many parts of the rocket during the wet dress rehearsal in March and April. The earliest launch, according to the agency, will be in May, but this may easily be pushed out to summer of 2022. So this summer, the Starship is still being tested by SpaceX, but Musk promises it will launch in 2022 for an orbital test by very least. The Starship, like the SLS, might face delays, and bringing the rocket to a point where it can, you know, can make journeys to the Moon or Mars is still a long way off, unfortunately. Now, are these ships reusable? The SLS is a one-time use system. The Starship, on the other hand, will be SpaceX's first entirely reusable rocket, replacing the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy, which had an expendable second stage. This is one of the reasons why Starship's flights might be 200 times less expensive per journey. A huge reusable craft costs considerably less than a small throwaway craft, CEO Elon Musk said in 2019. Now, I mean, the biggest question is, can it go to Mars? Yes. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It feels good, man. Both rockets are intended to transport humans to Mars. NASA intends to leverage the lessons learned from the Artemis flights to improve the development of the Mars missions, which will be completed using the Block 1B and Block 2 designs. SpaceX has set a lofty aim of launching the first humans to the Moon in the 2020s. In addition to this, NASA announced on Friday that the Artemis 1 cabin and launch vehicle had had a propellant malfunction during its third wet dress rehearsal. A comprehensive run-through of a launch, including fueling without actually lifting off, pushing the moon-bound rocket's timeline back another week. In its wet dress rehearsal phase, the mission, which is an unscrewed Orion capsule atop a space fly system, SLS again, rocket planned for a brief trip around the moon before humans launch aboard Artemis 2, has had a number of setbacks. This is when ground control performs a series of drills and scenarios as if it were launch day. A liquid hydrogen leak on the tail service terminal unit made it dangerous to continue the test during its third wet dress rehearsal, and especially given the proximity to liquid nitrogen. The umbilical plate, which connects the primary rocket to its smaller side tanks, had a tiny liquid hydrogen leak. Uh-oh, but don't worry, the Artemis team's strategy is to start small and see what answers they can come up with before taking more dramatic actions. All right, what do you think of all this? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. We'd love to meet you down there. With this, we reach the end of the video. So thank you again for all your love and support. I'm going to miss you. We appreciate your input. Thanks again for watching. And I hope to see you again tomorrow. Take care.